Hello, so you know when you find a game and you think it's pretty bad, but after you play it for 5 hours, you think it's really amazing? Well, this is the one. This is exactly what a fun game is like, and it has all the fun without any of the tedious stuff. So I think this will be a single player game, but you'll be fighting people, or how should I put it? You'll be fighting the builds of other people. Yeah. So we only have two classes right now. And depending on what class you choose, as you can see, I have a rank for each class. It will be a totally different loadout. As you can see, we have other slots, we have other bonuses for the bag. Okay, let's just play the game. So you can increase your storage by buying various items. Some of them will be a free row one, some of them will be... Anyway, there will be different shapes and sizes, and some will have small bonuses. You can attach them to your current one. You cannot move it after it's attached. Piggy. The piggy banks are really bad. Don't buy them, but I just like the more or less the meta. And you can win. You have to win all of your battles, and you can also lose 4 times. 5 means you game over. Now the cool thing about it is that when you start playing, you'll think, well, it's an easy and simple game. No complex interactions. Wrong. Oh, she has the garlic, so we'll lose. Just that extra item will help her win. Oh, we won. I guess we got lucky with the poison application, because as you can see, 25% to inflict one more poison. So one every second, and 25 chance to inflict another one on activation. Well, to be honest, I really like the broom, but the broom is hard to use most of the times, and you can sell them for half of that price, and the game becomes really, really complex the more you play it. What do I need from here? Well, I guess I can take the rarity card. So these are items that influence what appears in the shop. And I think these are just players that made the build or something like that. I might be wrong. But the game is, I think, in single player though. We lost because she had more healing, a lot more healing, or that player had more healing. Oh, well, no, I think it's okay. Yeah, let's buy the onion as well. Now, I'll just play this one very slowly. As you can see, the items are activating. This is one use. 35 armor. Health potion, so it will activate the health potion. It's really hard to get through armor in the beginning of the game. We won just because we had a little extra damage. And this is where things get tricky. As you can see, if you have certain items, you can make better version of those items. So if you combine these two items for one round, if you keep them near each other for one round, you'll get another version of them. Dark Saber. Vampiric Armor. Vampiric Gloves. And I've unlocked some of them. The slimes are the ones that have the most energy. Poison Dagger. As you can see, some of them have a bit of an animation. I wish all of them had an animation, to be honest. And you are learning and you are doing these combinations. You also can have... You can also reserve them. So you don't have to buy them straight away. See, it's showing me I can interact them. So you'll get the magic staff if we do it like that. Stamina usage is high. That means we'll not be able to use all of our attacks. There are other ways to increase your max stamina and also your stamina regeneration, but we'll not talk about that. Let's just keep playing. I'll explain a little more the second run. Yeah, we lost we lost badly. And now we have this one. So as you can see, previously the broom was 1.5 stamina cost. Don't worry too much about it. You will need to read a lot about them, but after you learn, you will understand them much better. So as you can see, this has accuracy of 90, stamina cost is 1, damage is 4 to 6. So the DPS is 2.8. This is 1 per second because it's such a slow hitting weapon, but it's basically it doesn't cost you any stamina. That's the point of it. And as you can see, it can destroy armor for each free slot in front of it. So that means if you put it, let's say, over here and you have free slots up there, it can destroy armor. So that's really good. We still have a lot of money. the sand over there. Okay, and this is where things will get very tricky. We'll need to change all of this. I like the piggies. The piggies, believe me, they are not worth caring with you, but I still do it. Stamina usage is medium. This is actually an item that I just take to combine with another one. The potions are very nice as well. This is stamina regeneration. As you can see, this is a legendary item. I don't really play with potions because... well, they're not that good, but I think I should just take them so I can get the interactions and unlock other stuff. So, okay, let me compare this. So, 1.5 stamina, 2.4. As you can see, it's basically a lot more damage, 5% more accuracy. Cooldown is a little bigger, but that doesn't matter. And when you have mana, you deal 6 additional damage and increase the damage by 2. To generate mana, you'll just need, of course, more items. Yeah, I'll take the potion. The models are also pretty nice. Yeah, now we have a lot of damage, and the enemy doesn't have a lot of damage. Oh, but it's winning because it has more healing. If you can buy the wooden sword with 2 whetstones, you'll get another sword, and then you can get another one. This is also pretty good, the blueberries. The dagger is very nice to take because it can be combined with a lot of items. Now, technically I don't need the extra damage from the whetstone. So let's put it... I want one more extra gold. You also have to rotate them, see? And if you don't rotate them, they don't work. The Death's Kite is also a very good item, as you can see. Items inflict double the poison, so that means they only inflict 2, maybe 3 with the storage coffin. But it has a stamina cost of 2, and it also has a pretty short cooldown, so that means this item will destroy all of your stamina. So you cannot attack any longer unless you have this weapon. I mean, you only have one attack if you use this weapon. As opposed to these ones, which are for total combined cost of 2. So if you do all of the DPS math, so that's 2.4, 5.2, it's almost the same DPS. The accuracy is different, but it will have other uses in a bit. And this also has a weird shape, as you can see. It's really a skite. Oopsie, I forgot to put this one over here. Oh, this will be an easy fight, so... what is... people in the game or bots will be using very, very niche builds. So this is basically the you are hurting yourself build. I'm just taking a lot of damage by attacking every time. And I don't have a lot of healing items, but we are stacking poison on the enemy. That's the only reason we'll win, because the poison is pretty strong. We need a few rerolls. Okay, I like the Hungry Blade as well with the Mana Orb. The pig is quite nice as well. So we have 12. Yeah, let's reserve that. No, the shield was a bad idea. Usually I just take it because we need some defense. You cannot only use offensive items. Mana first. The blueberries are quite nice because you gain mana, but also they activate. So that means they can inflict poison on the enemy as well. I guess it's a 25% chance every 4 seconds, but it really adds up. And this, as you can see, gives you one stack of Vampirism, which means one health when you're hitting with a melee weapon. But the problem is, okay, this has a very good stamina cost, but the damage is quite low, and it actually uses 3 slots as opposed. If you do the math for all of the DPS with the slots, you'll actually be amazed at how complex the game is. It's pretty balanced. There are some builds that are busted, but overall it's a very balanced game. More than you would expect, to be honest. Currently we're getting away with just getting weapons, but sooner or later we'll have to get defensive items as well. Now, this attacks every 1.4 seconds. Okay, this will get very tricky. So let's see how I want to do this. Since this is an item that activates 10% faster, I will put the garlic over there. It removes the vampires from the enemies. I'm getting very unlucky with finding another little stone. Oh, I really want this book as well, because it cleanses and heals as well. And with mana you can become invulnerable. I guess we can take that. So if I don't have any healing, it will be very bad. So you either need armor, healing, or regeneration, or lifesteal. Yeah, the power of capitalism. I guess I can modify it a little more, doesn't matter. Yeah, this is an easy fight, because the enemy doesn't have anything to damage me, really. So I guess it kind of shows that that enemy can have also pretty bad builds. Wait, why am I losing? Why did I lose? Oh, because of the little dragon. Yeah, you can... Okay, I'll show you next time. You can also see what you did wrong or what you could have changed. No, I don't want... Well, this is for sale, but it's kind of late to get more of those anyway. Yeah, let's get the book now, because we are lacking in defenses. This also gives us one max stamina. Let me show you the combat log. I didn't show you the combat log. Oh, the Falcon Blade. How do you create this one? I'm not sure how. Items trigger 35% faster, so it's related to something that makes items trigger faster. Probably the gloves then? Quest log. Quest log. Battle log. So you can see everything that happened with you and your opponent. Very nice. Now, sadly, I tend to get too many spaces for my inventory and not getting enough items. I'll just buy this one because I like getting more space. I can sell the onion. I'll need to buy the pestilence flask. The rarity of the items is important, but as you can see, the more you play, the more you see the items change over time. So yeah, at this point I should probably have more armor, or at least an armor, but I don't. Look at that. Oh, that's kind of a overpowered build in a way. Doesn't have a lot of damage, but as you can see, it's overbuffing one item and also a lot of healing. And I lost because of all of that healing. And that's it, we died and we have to restart. Okay, let's play again, but this time we'll play it more safe. I mean, usually I play better, but now I'm just... I don't know, I just want to experiment a little bit, because I want to find all of the recipes. Okay, let's play more serious now. By the way, get all of the things that will help you survive in the first run. The broom is actually pretty good, because if the opponent misses, it gets a blind stack. Actually, if the opponent misses, you attack for free. So the Falcon Blade is definitely the gloves combined with something else. Maybe the rapier? I don't know, we'll take them anyway. Put them over there. Banana is for healing and stamina, so if you have a lot of food in your inventory, if you have a lot of space, you'll be able to do some crazy things with them. The frying pan also, I don't know, it's a lot of damage up front in the beginning. The pan with food near it is overpowered in a bit, in a way. Yeah, look at this. The armor basically doubles the HP in the beginning. But because of the poison, we survived. We survived and thrived and won. So we'll gain a lot of armor. 25% faster is actually quite a good upgrade. Because that's about 1 second. And also removes vampires from the enemy, because it's garlic. Yeah, I have no choices over here. I'm not really getting good items. Oh, this is 100% one. Oh, might be a little closer than I thought. I lost? And sometimes it also comes down to luck. I really like piggies. Again, piggies are a very bad idea, but you can... How to put it? You can basically win the entire game if you just buy enough piggies, but I think they are nerfed, because earlier I read on the forum that they're much stronger. Probably you gain 2 more or I don't know. Apparently they're not really worth buying unless you have a lot of space. Stamina usage is high because this is one stamina which I should probably not use. Yeah, I also need the armor. The armor, weirdly enough, doesn't show up too often. Perfect. Yeah, okay. So next fight will have a lot of stuff to work with. Sometimes you just get unlucky and there's nothing you can do about it. But as you can see, we had more healing than that other character. And also put it like this. Yeah, let's put it like that so I can put the armor over there. Well, this is going to take a while until we get all of the items we need. That's a lot of healing, but I think we will overpower it because we have a lot of damage. Oh no, we didn't. Oh, it's on sale. So this is one of the more interesting interactions of the game. We have to... yeah, this is going to require us to modify a lot of stuff. If you feed it 2 mushrooms... so this is more or less a healing item. Well, it's a pet, but it's an item. If you feed it certain things, it will transform into something else. With the blood amulet, blood gobert, poison gobert, steel gobert... and I don't think the other ones are related to something above the book or something. No, I think we can... no, I think this is a little better. I want more defensive items this time. Stamina usage was very low. Okay, at this point I don't really like the broom anymore, so we'll sell it. I guess I can just put it in my inventory for other reasons. So now we have a lot of poison attacks and a lot of healing, plus the armor, which is great. Oh, man, she stacked a lot more poison on us because she had a poison battle. The flasks are... the poison flasks are great, but at some point they just lose all of their utility, so that's why I don't like to use them. Of course, they can also be much more overpowered if you know how to use them, but nope. The vampiric armor is one of the better ones to get, so we'll get that. These are just great to generate mana. At one point or another, we'll need more mana. Look at this, it's actually such a good item. It only gives you 2 vampirism for 9 gold. That's not really worth it, but in the long run, you can combine it with other items to make it much more useful. Yeah, let's make it like this. So as you can see, food interacts with each other, so you'll have more healing and more stamina. So you can basically fill your inventory with bananas and other food types, and you can Just restore more stamina and attack a lot more times, but that means you need more weapons, so now don't have room for armor. You see, healing is going very well for us. I'll let this one play slower, but so many weapons. Yeah, just too many weapons. So now it converts health into armor and you get... So this is a build that requires to have a lot of healing. Oh wow, everything is so cheap now. Well, I have to take it. Reserve that one. This interacts with the... It shows you over here. You have to feed the Gobert some items, the lightsaber and some other things apparently. Those two are reserved. Let's have more slots because we really need more slots. Stamina usage is low, so that means I can use it. Yeah, the wooden sword. Yeah, I think at some point I should just give up on the wooden swords. They're not really helping as much as I want. The lightsaber interacts with the vampiric armor. Oh no, it's interacting with those items on the shelf, okay. So for this I would need regeneration, but I don't have a regeneration, and as you can see it's a temporary effect as well. Regeneration is from the little herb bags. Here you just have to have a lot of blueberries, but I don't have blueberries, they're quite hard to find. Stamina is medium, medium is good. Okay, let's see how our build is doing now. Now we have everything we need, armor, damage, survivability, we have everything going for us, so this is a fight we cannot lose. Unless we get a lot of poison stacks like this. We'll die. Maybe. No, we won because we had a lot more survivability. Like the sand. Yeah, this is basically just for the damage at this point, which is pretty good. But you definitely want something else. Yeah, now sadly this means I don't have anything to work with. So we might lose this the next fight. Actually, we'll probably lose it 100%. Because look at this, we have nothing to work with, we just need an extra round to upgrade stuff. Let's see how lucky you get with the opponent. Oh, yeah, this could go either ways. Health, regeneration and cleansing. I think we can win because we have a lot of armor and enemies based on physical attacks. Yeah, we'll win. Poison is stacking. As you can see, my style is to... How do you make the Falcon Blade? It's so annoying that I don't know it. And this will deal damage for each debuff stack on our opponent. And if I had mana, I mean, I have some mana generation. I would even inflict more stuff. I think some of the interactions need you to have more items or combine items already, so that's why the other combinations are harder to get than these ones. So 1.4, 2.5. You can also do it like this, as you can see, it's going to be a lot of damage. I also want to take this one because I want to see what the interaction is with it. But it's 4 slots. I have a suspicion this will make the Falcon Blade. But how? You can see the items on other players or enemies, and sometimes you can figure it out. So this has a Falcon Blade had the chance for item trigger to be faster, but how do you combine this? It should be the rapier and the gloves, but it doesn't show like they're interacting. The genie lamp also doesn't have anything for now, or at least I don't understand. I guess we'll just have to go like this. Maximum greed. No, not the banana. Yeah, let's focus on winning. Okay, fine game. I think I just need more mana at this point. Okay, so it's kind of annoying that sometimes you just have to move everything around, but it's so cool. I guess I could buy another gem, and I also need something to cleanse the... Okay, actually no, it's okay. No, it'll be okay. Trust me, it'll be okay. What could go wrong? That's a lot of potions. I think I survived because the enemy didn't get to the chance to use those last potions. Oh, thank you game, you gave me a lot more room to work with. I'll have to buy the armor at some point. Pineapples are good, but it's 3 slots sadly. Still a very good food type. Because it's also a healing item, I should probably take this since my healing is lacking. No, must resist the... No. Yeah, I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do right now. Play around with this for a very long time and we'll still not figure out the right combination, so let's just play. Yeah, we just didn't have enough survivability like I said. Oh, we got so lucky. And that's why the armor is so good. Yeah, let's buy it straight away. Yeah, I guess this will look nice. That over there. So if you leave the slots free over there, you will get 2 stacks of regeneration, which is kind of nice. Let's put the onion over there. This is so useless, I cannot believe this is so useless, because I cannot find one more whetstone. So okay, I'll only get the wooden sword as long as I see at least one whetstone. Ah, let's go for maximum greed. The game is actually divided into rounds, but... Well, that's a little... That's a lot of defense. That's a lot of poison stacks. So as you can see, I can remove some of the poison stacks thanks to the armor and the poison goblet. But I don't think it will be enough because we are not inflicting enough damage on the enemy. And the poison just keeps stacking more and more. We might be able to... No, no. We won that by a millimeter. That's actually a much better combination. Oh man, I really wish I would find out the last interactions. I don't know, probably it's a waste of time to do it, but again, I just like the game too much. Yeah, at this point I think the gloves are kind of useless anyway. Yeah, this is a much better option. Even though it's not really maximum efficiency, it should be more than enough. Oh, this doesn't work. So see, it shows you if it works or not. So basically these items are junk, so I guess we'll leave that where it was. Yeah, let's juggle them. Yeah, I'm not sure what to do over here. Also, you can unlock the cards. The cards are actually pretty strong, but again, it's more luck-based, so you'll get access to cards, but I don't like it. It's too much luck involved getting the cards. Or maybe the other items are made with the cards, and I should really get the cards at some point. Yeah, probably. This is the potion belt. Well, I can get the vampiric gloves, but that will not really help me. I want the vampiric dagger. Because the vampiric gloves don't help that much anyway. So don't have any potions. I guess you can just maximize our damage output. Yeah. It's a lot of fun. I'll probably play this after I'm finished recording as well. I don't think we have enough damage to win. Yeah, too much sustain. Boo. Okay, I think you have seen enough. This is a very fun game and all of those combinations are really, really fun to do. I have to play and see what combinations I can get with the cards themselves to get the rest of the items. Ah, super cool game. I'll play it a lot when it's released. Even though it's an auto battle, it's definitely one of the best. Bye!